Effective cattle handling is a lot like dancing with a partner. You have to take the lead and use the right pressure to let your partner know where to go. However, if your signals are unclear, you end up stepping on each other's toes. In cattle handling, it's important to know that a cow is surrounded by two invisible zones. The area immediately around a cow is called the flight zone. If you step inside the cow's flight zone, she will quickly escape from you. This flight behavior served her well as a prey animal, but can work against you on the farm. If you are working with a group of animals, you might lose control of the entire herd by stepping into just one animal's flight zone. It takes quite some time to calm them down again, so it's best to stay out of the flight zone. Instead, we will work with what's known as the pressure zone. It is the bubble around the flight zone. A cow will try to keep the bubble of her pressure zone intact and will instinctively move away from intruders. As you can see here, when the handler steps into the pressure zone of the cow, she will casually move away to maintain her pressure zone. Each cow has her own pressure and flight zone. These are herd animals with different sized pressure zones. When you are working with one, you might actually be affecting several other cows that have larger pressure zones. As you work with cows, pay attention to when they begin to move as you approach them. Start with as little pressure as possible and increase as needed. Putting pressure on the cow is a gradual process and doesn't work like the flip of a switch. You'll be surprised how little pressure can make a big difference. A number of factors in the environment can affect a cow's pressure zone and how she reacts to you. For instance, a fence will already put pressure on her, so you won't need to move as far into her pressure zone to make her move. Putting pressure on a cow from the side also enables you to use elements in the facility's design to further guide where the cow naturally wants to go. The important thing is that you give the cow a clear opening for where you want her to go. It takes out the guesswork for her. Similarly, if you are working with other handlers, make sure they are not standing in the opening where you want the cows to go. Handling cows this way requires that you constantly adjust your approach in response to her movements. Although you might have a plan for your moves ahead of time, be prepared to adjust according to their response. When handling cows, remember to stay out of the flight zone and use the pressure zone to influence their movement. Adjust your behavior and pressure based on what the cow is telling you, and give clear commands to the cows to make them move as desired.